Now, our next speaker is the leader of the biggest public service union in this country. Please give a welcome to the best champion for public service workers, the one and only, the General Secretary of UNISON, Dave Prentis.
Are there any UNISON members in the park here today? Where's the Boomers Anglers? As General Secretary, I really am proud, on behalf of the tens of thousands of UNISON members here today, marching an ocean of purple and green, UNISON members marching not just for their own jobs, but for the people and the communities that they serve. Our people seeing on a daily basis the devastation these cuts are having, as the sick, the elderly, go without care, as young people, our children, lose their chance. 1 million young people unemployed. 50% of young black kids leaving school, no job to go to, no hope. And what we see, more than anything, is communities blighted by unemployment and by poverty, and ignored by a ruthless coalition. This coalition, Tories and Liberal Democrats alike, with no democratic mandate whatsoever, taking a chainsaw to our public services. And we are told that there is no alternative. We are all in this together, but they're liars. And we are here to tell them today that there are alternatives. Clegg and Cameron could have the guts to go back to the banks, the SPIBs, the speculators. Tell them on our behalf, you created this mess, you clear it up. But they say, we can't do that. We can't hit the bankers and lead the country. Well, good riddance to them. And then they say, with breathtaking hypocrisy, they take benefits away from the poor, the vulnerable, and the disabled in our society. They take away our jobs, our pay, our pension, and they hand over our National Health Service to their big business friends, and letting our communities feel the pain. Well, I say this. If there's money to bail out the bankers, if there's money for bankers' bonuses, if there's money for war, then there's money available for our public services. And never mind the pay freeze for our members. How about a pay freeze for the bankers? We've had enough of their greed, their arrogance. It's their turn to pay. It's the rich, not our communities, not the vulnerable, not the poor, not the disabled. It's the rich in the city who should be doing more for less. More for their country, less for themselves. The disgrace, the absolute disgrace of a UNISON cleaner in one of our hospitals paying more than the chief executive of a multinational company in tax. It's unfair, it's immoral, and we will oppose it. So let's make it clear, let's make it really clear today to this coalition, that we are standing for the millions, not the millionaires. The millions of us that believe in a decent society, honesty, compassion. We want those in power to hear our anger. We want them to see the faces of those here today, our care workers, our nurses, our teaching assistants, our young people, all abandoned by this coalition that cares more for its friends in big business than ordinary, hard-working people and families like ourselves. And let's make it clear. Today is one day. Today is a magnificent day. But tomorrow we march on. We will march. We will march to build an opposition. We will march to mobilise, to organise in every city, in every town, in every part of the United Kingdom. We will grow louder, we will get stronger. Our own coalition to save our services, to break the pay freeze, to defend our pensions. And we will march in our thousands, and we will vote in our millions to ditch this coalition once and for all. But when David Cameron talks about his big society, let him hear the roar of our big society here today. This is a really big society. David Cameron, hear the roar. Hands off our public services, tax the banks, and save our National Health Service.